Welcome students, parents and guardians, teachers, administrators, and whoever else is watching this video. It is with great honor and privilege that I stand here to commemorate the very best of the Charlottetown Borough Class of 2020. For starters, I want to say that I am extremely proud that I am a member of the Charlottetown Borough Class of 2020. When I was writing this address, I looked at other valedictory speeches, but none fit the Borough Class of 2020. So I researched some quotations about education and found one that I felt fit our class. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Intelligence plus character. That is the goal of true education." Bearing this in mind, I would have to say that this graduating class has received an excellent education these past 12 years. I have seen firsthand and been a recipient of the character of this group of individuals and how they have come together to aid others in need at any cost. Some prime examples of this are the Bocce Ball Tournament for Special Olympics, Easter Seals, and the Rudolph Campaign. During the Rudolph Campaign, my student councilmates and I pestered other students for their pocket change as they returned from lunch break at the bus doors. The response by all students, especially the seniors, was overwhelming. On a personal level, students created a semi-viral Don't Stop Believing video for my brother Trent and I when we were in need of support. We're all here as high school graduates, however, we've all had different paths to get here. For myself, it was humble beginnings at Sherwood Elementary, where the Sherwood kids learned about caring, loving, and sharing, and we continuously played with Beyblades, Pokemon, Silly Bands, and Foursquare. At Stone Park, a lot of us learned to express ourselves and to please be good to one another, while vowing to never, ever, ever eat in the halls. Now we find ourselves ending our journey here at Charlottetown Borough, where we got a full-size locker, a choice of courses, and more responsibilities. Little did we know when we started at Charlottetown Borough that our school was a treasure chest of memories just waiting to be opened. On some days, there were students here at 7 a.m., and often there were students that didn't leave until 5 or 6 p.m. No matter our interests, there was something for everyone at Charlottetown Borough, as the borough was much more than a school, but rather a community. Some fond memories being at Charlottetown Borough include Mr. Tom's polynomial dance, playing Family Feud in the cafeteria at lunch, listening to Mr. Hughes call the smart board a dumb board, and watching championship basketball games at UPEI, where there was no shortage of school spirit. I think it is evident that our senior year was not ideal. We have been robbed of a lot of things. Some of us have had our final rugby, badminton, softball, and our track and field seasons taken away from us. Others have been deprived of a once-in-a-lifetime useful experience, and all of us have been robbed of everyday memories that we made in the halls of Charlottetown Borough. Leon C. Edison, based on Charles Darwin's ideas, said, "It is not the most intellectual of the species that survives. It is not the strongest that survives, but the species that survives is the one that is able to adapt to and to adjust best to the changing environment in which it finds itself." My pals from Psychology 621X may be familiar with that, but what he means is that adaptability to changing circumstances is even more important than intelligence and strength. This quote is very fitting for the graduating class, as the resiliency of the class of 2020 is moving. Despite having to stay indoors and away from friends for 2 months, the class of 2020 did not quit. We're still here, graduating with our friends and teachers. I think this speaks to the character of the graduating class, and it's obvious this graduating class is destined to change the world someday. The class of 2020 is the first graduating class that was born after 9/11. This was an event that changed the world forever. The fact that we're graduating during a global pandemic, another event that has changed the world, is another fortifying fact that the class of 2020 will be positive world changers. Our time in school was all about learning, developing, and adapting. We now need these skills more than ever, for that is the way that the class of 2020 will build a better future, not just for ourselves, but for our province, our country, and our world. In these unprecedented times, we look forward to the future and will leverage our adaptability to make the world a better place. In closing, I would like to firstly thank our teachers, custodians, and administrators who have worked diligently to help us succeed. Your work has not come unnoticed. From telling us to put our phones away to making home learning videos as entertaining as possible, to allowing us the opportunity for a test retake, everything you've done has helped us get to where we are. Secondly, I would like to send thanks to all parents, step-parents, guardians, grandparents, and the rest of our families for being there for us from the time we were born to the moment we graduated high school and beyond. I would personally like to thank my parents and Trent, who sacrificed and did everything they could to see me succeed and have a great high school life. Finally, I would like to thank my peers, the class of 2020. Firstly, for allowing me to represent you on the student council for 3 years, as it has been an honor and a privilege. Secondly, thank you for being part of this experience. Each day at the Royal was an exciting and new day. I felt extremely privileged not only to be a Raider, but to experience it with the class of 2020, like working on a project with Reese and the rest of the student council, or watching Tyler Henry fix yet another teacher's smart board, or even walking into a class and getting to sit next to another person with the last name that starts with N because of those ever popular seating plans. It would not have been the same without all of you. I will forever be proud to say that I graduated alongside each and every one of you. Whatever field you may be entering in the future, whichever lifestyle you choose, and whatever life choices you make, I wish you all nothing but the best of luck. The definition of character is the mental and moral qualities distinctive to an individual. After spending 3, 6, or 12 years with you all, I know that there are great mental and moral qualities distinctive